Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. On Friday's Netcast, we talked about how people can use a 3D perspective on a pie chart to misrepresent the data. Today, I want to talk about cone and pyramid charts. Anytime that you see someone using these in a presentation, there's a pretty good bet that they're trying to hide something. We have a really simple data set here that shows how a nonprofit is spending their money. 50% on research, 15% on grants, and 35% is going to administration. That's probably kind of high. If we create a standard column chart from that, you'll be able to see the story. Expenses, grants, and administration, this huge administration block up here. Now let me make that chart a little bit smaller so we'll be able to fit two of them on the screen. There we go. Okay, now in this second chart, I want to change the chart type to a cone or a pyramid chart. These charts severely misrepresent the data because whatever is closest to the bottom actually expands and looks like it's much larger, and whatever category is closest to the top becomes much more narrow. Now, if you have to explain why you're spending so much on administration at this nonprofit, which chart would you rather use? The chart on the left is going to show this huge block. The chart on the right makes it seem like it's just a tiny little bit of money being spent at the top. You can add a title to that chart on the right that says expenses are minimal and very few people will question it. Anytime you're sitting in a presentation and you see someone using either a cone or a pyramid chart, stop and think about it. They're probably trying to misrepresent the data. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.